بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله وكفى وسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى ما بعد قال الله تبارك وتعالى في الكلام المجيد والفرقان الحميد بعد اعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يا ايها الذين امنوا اذكروا الله ذكرا كثيرا فسبحوه بكره واصيلا في مقام اخر قال الله تبارك وتعالى واذكروا الله كثيرا لعلكم تفلحون في مقام اخر قال الله تبارك وتعالى فاذكروا الله قياما وقعودا وعلى جنوبكم في مقام اخر قال الله تبارك وتعالى واذكر اسم ربك بكرة واصيلا في مقام اخر قال الله تبارك وتعالى واذكر اسم ربك وتبتل اليه تبتيلا في مقام اخر قال الله تبارك وتعالى واذكر ربك في نفسك تضرعا وخيفا ودون جهر من القول بالغدو والاصوات ولا تقم من الغافلين قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم Today I am starting the bayan or the muraqabah meditation. This is the need of the time. About 80% people are suffering from depression and anxiety. Maybe young and old, husband and wife, young or old. And as a result of that, they go to the drug. So that I thought it's very better to talk on this subject. So I'm talking about meditation, muraqabah. These are at least three bayan. The first bayan today, what is muraqabah? What is meditation? What this zikr, a silent zikr of the heart, zikr of qalbi. All these ayat I quoted before you. There are so many other ayat mubarakah in the Quran and Majeed which talk about this very subject for the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. All these ayat show that we should do remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in our heart. The few ayat mubarakah I will just give the meaning, not all of them. فَإِذَا قَضَيْتُمْ الصَّلَاةَ فَاذْكُرُوا اللَّهَ قِيَامًا وَقُعُودًا عَلَى جُنُوبِكُمْ Meaning, and once you have finished your prayer, Salat, then remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala while standing, sitting, and lying on your side. Ajib. You cannot take tasbih, do zikr, but you have to work also. You have to drive the car also. But in that condition, you have to lie down rest also. Then you can do zikr. And that zikr is zikr qalbi, zikr from the heart. As a mubaraka, was kurisma rabbika, but the battal alayhi tabtila. Remember the name of your Lord. Your Rabb, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, sustainer, and devote yourself to Him with complete devotion exclusively. Subhanallah, other ayat-e mubarakah, in which very clearly Allah is talking about the zikr in the heart. وَذْكُرَبَّكَ فِي نَفْسِكَ تَذَرُّ وَخِيفَةً وَدُونَ الْجَهْرِ مِنَ الْقَوْلِ بِالْغَذُوبِ وَالْأَصْوَالِ وَلَاتُكُمْ مِنَ الْغَافِلِينَ Remember your Lord within yourself. Remember your Lord within yourself and in your heart. In humility and in the fear without speaking loudly. In the morning and the evening. And do not be among those who are heedless, who are just absent-minded. Don't be that. Subhanallah. Allah is the personal name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, our Rabb. The battle mean over here, cut yourself from entire creation and connect yourself with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and fulfill the rights of the Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as well as his makhluk. What the meaning of cutting yourself from whole creation mean empty your mind from all kind of devilish thoughts as part of your desire and your nafs and your evil desires. Just do zikr with a tasbih. The zikr is not only zikr. That's okay. But you have to do zikr with your heart. Remember your heart. Remember your Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in your heart also. It is not easy to remember him because shaitan is sitting in our mind. Nafs is sitting there. They always take our mind away. Before Nabuwa, he was declared the prophet in Ghar-e Hira. In Ghar-e Hira, in the cave of Hira, Rasulullah Akram sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to take his food for 1 week. At that time, there was no salat, no fasting was there. Only the zikr Allah. He used to seven days staying in Ghar-e Hira, only connecting his heart, disconnecting from the makhluk and connecting his heart to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in zikr and zikr contemplation. Alone. Allah Akbar. Even Hazrat Thanvi Rahmatullah Alayh, Muhammad Hazrat Thanvi Rahmatullah Alayh, to his students, he used to tell them, stay 40 days in my spiritual place. For 40 days, no talking to nobody at all. Period. Keep silent. It's a big thing. Even Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, sometimes at home, he was in such condition, and Aisha radiallahu ta'ala, Anna asked something, she said, who are you? Aisha. Man anta, who are you? Aisha. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to connect his heart sometime with Allah totally. The muraqabah, the meditation from the raqib mean being supervised from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who is the guardian, who is watching, to empty our mind from all kind of worries and cares and presenting yourself with only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, thinking about His sifat only. Some ulama says, what the muraqabah meditation? To take one idea and shift yourself in the same idea. Forget everything else, especially in sifate attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Example, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is a Sami. He is Basir. Where we are, He is there. So do muraqaba, huwa ma'akum ana ma'kuntum. Sit down, relax, only think, my Allah is watching me. He is watching me. He is listening me. He is watching me. He is listening me. When we do muraqaba and have this tamreen and mashq and exercise, as a result of that, we will feel, even walking in the market area, business side, that Allah is watching me. When we have this in the mind, always Allah is watching me, then I cannot commit any sin, which is observable sin. Allah is listening to me. You got this muraqaba, then you cannot make wrong use of tongue. You cannot speak wrong. You cannot call bad name to anybody. You cannot be rude to anybody. So, this is meditation. This is a spiritual exercise. And this is the first ladder, first step to have spiritual knowledge, spiritual ilm. Muraqaba is to watch over, to observe over your life every minute, how I am leading my life. This is a muraqaba. Nobody can do tawbah, repentance, until he observe over himself what he did. Then he can only repent. If you think Allah observes me, then he can repent. Allah is watching me. He is considering me. Considering me. Then I will free myself from committing wrong deed. Muraqaba meditation is a state of awakeness of the heart. Sleeping is not sleeping and careless condition. If heart is pumping blood, means the soul is there. Sleeping heart is always taken over by shaitan. If we keep Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in our mind, then we cannot commit any kind of crime and any kind of disobedience. This meditation was in every religion in different form, like ibadat. You know, Hindu, Sikh, even America, some Americans do also meditation. They got it from the Islam. And a lot of some seminar happened about the meditation to help the people to meditate. Why people go mental? Because think. Think this, think that, think this, think that. So to control that kind of mind condition, hither and there, muraqaba is a must. What is muraqaba? To grasp in fully in the anything to whom you love. Allah Akbar. Musa alayhi salatu wasalam went for 30 days. What was there in Kohetur? This muraqabah, meditation. And then he had was added 10 days more. It was itikaf, seclusion at Kohetur. Then heart and mind open for the wahi of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then he was blessed with the tablets. Maryam alayhi salam, she also used to muraqabah, itikaf. As a result of that, she was blessed. Lot of karamat, subhanallah. And she shook a trunk of the tree dry and fruit came down. So as a result of that, when we do muraqabah, then we get spiritual flight. Spiritually become very high. And we will bless with the miraj, mashallah, of our heart with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This muraqabah is not difficult. It's very, very easy. Only we have to empty our mind from all kind of other thoughts and concentrate. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is watching me. He is with me. To me, the muraqabah is a private channel. It's a private channel with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Even angels don't know that. Allah Akbar. Because we are remembering Allah within the heart. And that's possible. Even any kind of job we do, that's possible. Now I give few benefits of the muraqabah. With the muraqabah, heart battery is charged very fast. The muraqabah strengthens the memory power, which everybody needed. Muraqabah, meditation, strengthens decision power. Some people cannot make a decision. They can easily make a decision after having some practice of muraqabah. By meditation, muraqabah, you will have self-control power, which you need. Always, muraqabah will bless you self-control of the anger. This is the best, muraqabah's best medicine for anxiety and depression. You want peace of the heart. Through muraqabah, you can increase your peace of mind and peace of the heart. It also strengthens the concentration power which every student needs, especially for mathematics or for science, in the lab, for the scientist. Increase muraqabah, increase love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with high speed. with this muraqaba, you will have ability to control your sex desires or other desires which bring you evil. Muraqaba, enlighten your heart. It will make a strong connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This muraqaba is so blessed. Zikr, Allah loves us. That's why He, so many ayat, He commanded us to do this zikr with the heart. But unfortunately, how much time we devote every day, sit down, relax, to do zikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We have a lot of time for gossiping to each other, talking about dunya, this and that. A poor we make salat is ibadat. The zikr Allah is also ibadat. This is such ibadat which we can do 24 hours, every minute, every second. There are so many ayat of Quran about zikr Allah. Of course, zikr bil jahar, sometimes we teach our students zikr, loud zikr, to take some physical diseases also. And this muraqaba, this ibadat is full of sincerity. You're sitting, relaxing. You're doing zikr the heart. Nobody knows that. Even angels don't know that. So, alhamdulillah, today I mentioned before what is a muraqaba, what the main benefit of muraqaba. And moreover, benefit, this is we obeying the commandment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There are so many hundreds of ayat about zikr Allah. And obeying the sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, there is pure ibadat. Inshallah, in other bayan, we will talk about other aspects of muraqaba. What is the reality of muraqaba? And always we tell about how to do muraqaba. What are the etiquettes of muraqaba? Then, in the end, one full session will be about, we teach you practically how to muraqaba so that we will keep up ourselves free from anxiety and depression and filling up our heart with the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa akhir da'wana. أن الحمد لله رب العالمين سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين دعاء اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى سيدنا محمد وبارك وسلم ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار ربنا هب لنا من أزواجنا وذرياتنا قرة أعين واجعلنا للمتقين إماما سبحانك ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين آمين آمين آمين